Variable length arrays. So far what we were doing is, when I was declaring the array, I was also mentioning the size of the array. So I was saying something like this. I was saying int a of 10. So here I had my code. So before actually even asking the user from any input, I was fixing the size of the array. C provides you a way where you can allocate the size of the array or determine the size of an array at execution time. Let us say you read certain numbers from a user. Sometimes you read 10, sometimes you read 20. Sometimes you read 10,000, sometimes you read 500. So rather than allocating an array of maximum size of say 10,000, you can allocate or create an array of just the required size based on the need at that particular runtime or program. So in my previous initialization, as I had shown you here, the array size is decided at compilation time. But there is a way to create the size of an array at execution time. Let's take a look at an example and try to understand different concepts of it. So this variable n will hold the size of the array at runtime. This is the index used to travel through a single dimensional array. I am first asking the user, how many numbers do you want to enter? So the user sometimes may say 10, sometimes may say 1000, sometimes may say 10,000, sometimes may just say 5. So based on the value of n, I am defining or allocating space for an array saying a of n. So this space is allocated when the program is running, not when the program is compiled. So now what I'm doing is I'm asking the user to enter so many numbers. For I is 0, I less than n, plus plus I is going to happen later on. I am reading, let's say, 5 numbers into the single dimension array. Same what I am doing here is I am displaying those numbers from the array. So here what I have done in this particular statement, based on the numbers being entered at that particular point of time, I am allocating space for the array. So what it's doing is, the advantage of this is, I am preventing wastage of main memory because I am allocating only the space required as per the user's requirement. But there are a few rules associated with this particular usage of an array. You cannot have the keyword static int here. You cannot use the keyword static, and nor can you give it any initial values. The big advantage is that, as I told you, for every run based on the requirement, you can have the array resized or created to just use enough space as per the requirement. But the thing is, this is not very frequently used, because generally in C, we prefer to use a mechanism of dynamic memory allocation, which we will be discussing as we talk about pointers in the subsequent video lectures. But this is just a good concept to help you know that there is a possibility to create variable length arrays. A useful time when you can create variable length arrays is, suppose you have a function called main here, okay? And here you have another function, let's call it as test, okay? And every time you are calling test, the size of the array, let us say, keeps changing. In this case, it makes sense to allocate the size of the array every time dynamically, because anyway, these local variables are created every time when test is called and destroyed when every time test is done executing. So if you have a main and if you have a function and you are sure that the size of the array is going to be different every time you run, then it makes some sense to use a variable length array. I hope this clarifies your understanding of a variable length array.